All right. Tough day today, as you can imagine. It's hard to tell one of your good friends that the job that he has loved isn't one that he can continue to be in. And I have probably a unique appreciation for that, given how excited I am to be in this role. And I can only imagine how hard it would be to have somebody tell me that I couldn't do this anymore. A lot of things about John Groce that I hope we can celebrate as he makes his exit from the basketball program. Unbelievable optimism, his energy. He's someone who cares first and foremost about our student athletes. We never had any concerns about how he treated them. Our athletes left here better people, better students, better athletes. Wonderful, engaging member of our community. He was intelligent. He's a strong role model. A lot of things that when I met with him today, I told him there's so many things about you that would be on my list for any head coach. And that's absolutely, absolutely true. The challenge for me, of course, is that my decisions have to be based on what's in our best long-term interests. And for us, we have a basketball program that we all expect to compete for Big Ten and national championships year in and year out. I was here at the peak. I was here 10 years ago. I saw the energy. I felt the environment in State Farm Center. When you couldn't find a ticket, when every game was an event, every fan was in an orange shirt, the waiting list was thousands of people long to get a season ticket to an Illinois basketball game. I remember standing in the crowd and the hairs on the back of my neck stood up when the pregame video went on the board. It was "The Champ is Here." You guys remember that? The Al Lee video, the movie, "The Champ is Here." I've never forgotten the feeling in that place when that team took that floor and that video was on the board. That's what we're striving for, year in and year out. That was 10 years ago. And if we're not careful, it'll be 30 years ago. That's what I can't allow to happen. I've been evaluating the basketball program basically since the day I walked in the door a year ago. And this wasn't the culmination of one game. There wasn't a single moment where it was, this is it, this can't continue. It was an assessment that has been ongoing for a long time. Made the decision today rather than maybe after tomorrow for a few reasons. One, I felt like after the game on Thursday, I was able to sit down with some of our senior folks and really take full stock of the program. I was able to reach a point of peace with the decision that I felt was necessary. I'm not someone, once I make a decision like that one, to dally around and wait. I didn't think it'd be fair to John, to the other people with the program, once I knew what I wanted to do, to pretend that I didn't. And also, we also have to recognize that we're in a very competitive marketplace. This is essentially a game of musical chairs, and we don't want to be the person left standing when the music stops in terms of identifying our next head coach. We needed to put ourselves in the right position to go out and start to move more aggressively to identify who that coach might be. This afternoon, I met with John at about 1 o'clock, talked with him about my decision. He handled it exactly as I thought he would, with grace, with humility. His first concerns were with his family. His second thoughts were with his players. And his third thoughts were with the University of Illinois. Nowhere in there did he ask questions about himself. He was immediately thinking about other people. And I was very appreciative of his professionalism and the relationship that I hope I get to continue to have with him. We followed that meeting with a meeting with the team and with our coaching staff. We've communicated with the recruits. I look forward to having conversations with them in the days ahead. We will begin our search immediately. I can tell you that there will not be an announcement on Monday. This is, I told you when we went through the football process, that was a very unique situation. We won't be in a position to move that quickly. This will be a more traditional process than what we went through a year ago. I'd also remind you that a lot of great coaches are still coaching. They've got programs that they're leading. through the postseason, and we want to be respectful of their obligations. You know, a couple final thoughts, and then I'll wrap it up and take any questions. First, I just want to remind people in the room, and just as importantly, our fans, some good people lost their jobs today. And I understand the interest and that some people want to celebrate today. And today is not a celebration day. Today is a day where we recognize that there were a bunch of people who worked really hard on behalf of this university for the last 5 years. And I think it's easy to forget that these aren't people in a reality TV show. They're not actors in a play. They're real people with real dreams, real aspirations, real fears, and real families. They had a rough day today. And so the cameras are going to go off, and the writers are going to go away, and they're still going to have to pack up the boxes and find a new job, put their houses on the market, be away from their families. So let's be respectful of that. Understand, I wish people could see all the effort and the energy that goes into running a high major college basketball program. The sleepless nights, the anxiety, the interest. It is an incredibly intense experience. And these guys, for the last 5 years, have laid it on the line for this university. So we all owe them that debt of gratitude. Last thing I'll say, and then I'll take questions. The future's bright. Future for Illinois basketball is bright. It's an unbelievable program with almost unmatched tradition. As we go off and hit the marketplace and we start to consider different candidates, that's what we're looking for. Somebody who understands the tradition that exists here. Somebody who's a great fit for the University of Illinois and the rich history that we have with our basketball program. Illinois basketball will stand up and make us all proud again. And I'm excited to be a part of that process. Okay, let me take some questions.
Josh, when you hired Lovey, you made an unprecedented investment. Do you expect the same thing with basketball moving forward?
I do. I again, as I said with football, I would repeat that with basketball. We understand what's necessary to be competitive in today's environment, and you know we're willing to do what we need to do on the financial side to be sure that we get the best coach for our program. I would caution people though that. Dollars don't necessarily equal quality, and so just because someone may be a $2.5 million coach doesn't mean they're any worse than a $4.5 million coach. Let's look at the substance behind the person before we hang a dollar figure on them and equate that to how good they are.
Josh, you talked to the assistants, and Jamal's going to be the interim, correct? And are the other coaches going to work with Jamal here as you? Perhaps get a bid tomorrow evening?
They will. So the rest of the coaching staff will stay intact. We expect that Darren Hertz will be elevated from his special assistant position to one of the actual assistant coaches on staff. So, you know, those guys, as I just said, I mean, they've laid their hearts on the line for this place for the last 5 years, and they're committed to seeing it through to the end.
Will you consider Jamal Walker in your coaching search?
I really don't want to comment in any specificity on the search. I will tell you that we'll consider anybody in the search. You know, we'll leave no stone unturned in trying to identify the right person. And so I'm certainly not ready today to start taking people off the list.
Josh, you mentioned.
Go ahead, Lauren.
Did John Groce ask to coach in the NIT, or is this your decision, his decision? How did that come out?
Yeah, John, I think if John had his choice, I think he would have liked to have coached through the end of the postseason. We felt like this was the right move for our program to go ahead and make a clean break today and put Jamal in the interim capacity. I appreciate John, really. Of course, I appreciate everything about him. And one thing that John is not is a quitter. And he certainly wanted to go out on his own terms, and I'm grateful for that. But we felt like the break today was the right move.
You mentioned he didn't want it to be 30 years since maybe that last high moment in Illinois basketball. What maybe you look for moving forward, you know, as steps to make sure that doesn't happen?
Well, it starts with leadership. And there's no magic formula to this stuff, right? You find the right leader, you surround that leader with great resources, and then you give them the room to go off and do a good job. And so we've got to find the right person, and it's imperative that we do that.
You said some guys lost their jobs today. Are any other assistants being let go? What's that process like right now?
Well, as typically would happen when you remove a head coach, all the assistants are put on notice that that their jobs will be ending as well. Certainly, the new coach will have the opportunity to have conversations with the new coach and meet with the outgoing assistants. And if he wishes to retain any of them, that would be his decision. But the expectation likely is that they'll move on to other things.
Josh, I know you talked about earlier wanting the atmosphere over at the State Farm Center to be like it was 10 years ago. Did the fact that the attendance had declined this past season have any effect on your decision today?
Any effect? Sure. Did it have the most important effect? No. Certainly, basketball, like football, is a little bit different than evaluating soccer, tennis, track, any other sport. There is a revenue component to it. That those two sports, and I've said this in a lot of different settings before, those two sports really pay the bills for the entire operation. And so that is a consideration, but I wouldn't call it a driving force.
Josh, you have the ninth best recruiting class in the country. How big did that factor into this evaluation? Are you confident in retaining them?
Well, it's certainly an important consideration. I've gotten to know most of those recruits throughout the process and look forward to talking with them over the course of the weekend. It did complicate things, right? Because it's unusual to have a program that has performed as ours has over the last few years, but to have a recruiting class that's as highly rated as ours is this year. So I hope that they will give us every opportunity to bring in a dynamic new coach, give that coach a chance to build a relationship with them, and then continue to want to be a part of the Fighting Illini. We're certainly excited about them, and I look forward to talking to them over the course of the next few days.
What are the most important traits you're looking for in your next coach?
Well, I think it's a little early for me to put that list out here, but I think a lot of things that anybody else would identify. Certainly, you want to try and find. I've already used this word once. Fit is really critical to me. You want to find somebody who appreciates the University of Illinois, who wants to be a part of this program in the long term. I think you want to find somebody, ideally, who has head coaching experience. Certainly a dynamic recruiter is critical. Someone who's a strong leader, high integrity. Basketball, as many of you know, can be a pretty slippery business, and that was one thing that I can say about John and his group is that I never once lost sleep over what our basketball staff was doing out on the recruiting trail or any other part of their work, and so that will continue to be a hallmark of our program, and I'm sure there's some other things, but those are just a few off the top of my head.
You said you made this decision today, but have you been looking for a head coach before or putting out feelers or anything else, or will you start this process today?
No, the process starts today. We've certainly been thinking about this for a while. And the decision, as I mentioned, was more made Thursday and kind of just executed today. But we have had people reach out to us for some time. I think there's been speculation, obviously, around the position for a while. But we'll get started in earnest today.
Did fan input have any part of your decision? There's obviously been a lot of uproar from fans. Who expects?
We have great fans, right? We have some of the best basketball fans in the country, and we've seen that this year. Again, the team didn't perform as well as we would have liked, but we had two great sellouts. We had a wonderful environment there for the Michigan State game a week ago. And so our fans continue to answer the bell at very critical moments, grateful for their support. I would say there's an awareness of how people feel, and I'm not sitting there reading everything that everybody has to say. I think certainly the way they express themselves in terms of buying tickets, not buying tickets is a consideration. But at the end of the day, I have to make the decision that I think is in the best interest of the program. And the fan voice is a voice, but it's certainly not the biggest voice that's considered in making these decisions.
they would have made the tournament this year, would you have kept John?
Well, you know, it's interesting because, as I understand it, there's still some people out there who are saying we're going to make the tournament tomorrow. And it's, you know, one of the reasons that I thought it was important to make the decision today was to make it very clear that, you know, that this decision is based on our performance. And it's not contingent on how a third party assesses that performance. And so if we're fortunate enough to get a bid tomorrow into the NCAAs or into the NIT, that was not a... a critical part of the decision once we reached that point late last week.
If you do get an NCAA tournament bid, what's the coaching decision going to be there, because Jamal has that two-game suspension?
Certainly aware of that, and you know, we've had some internal discussions. We'll deal with that once we come to it.
Before this season started, you know, your first really, you know, with John, did you have discussion with him about expectations or parameters or anything along those lines?
I did, and certainly John knew this was a big year for him and for our program. But you know, in terms of specifics, I'm always cautious, and those of you who have gotten to know me a bit, I don't like painting myself in a corner. And so I never said, if you do these things, you'll be here. If you don't do these things, you won't be. But I think he had a strong understanding of what we were looking to accomplish over the course of the year.
Josh, do you anticipate using a search firm to help you?
I don't.
You mentioned you talked to the players a little bit. How did that conversation go? And what was their reaction to
this? The conversation went fine. You know, it's a difficult moment. It's that environment, and I can relate to it on a very personal level, is pretty intense. You spend a lot of time with those people in terms of practices, travel. And you see a lot of very emotional ups and downs, wins, losses, playing time, no playing time. These guys are really their surrogate parents when they're here on our campus. And so a lot of emotion. People certainly care about, the players certainly care about their coaches. But I think I've worked really hard in my 12 months here to build a relationship with our team. And I hope that they have confidence and trust in me to make the best decision for the future of the basketball program. And I sensed, I don't want to put words in their mouth, but I sensed that was the case today.
Will they be practicing tomorrow?
You'd have to check with them. I think they're scheduled to practice tomorrow, yeah.
Just to be clear, Josh, did you say you did talk to some of the recruits, or you will this weekend?
I've communicated with them, but I have not spoken to them.
Josh, for you, this is a personal place for you. Obviously, you were here. You said it was, you know, that excitement 10 years ago, and you say, you know, if I thought it was very telling to say that, you know, that if you're not careful, it could become 30 years. This program has been closer to the bottom of the Big Ten than to the top, and a lot of people see this program like that now. For you, as the way you did with Lovey, how do you now sell this program as well going forward that you are confident that you can get back there?
Well, I think that's ultimately a big part of my job, is to go out and be an effective recruiter of my own for potential candidates to become our next head coach. I think we have unlimited potential here. We have $170 million that we just dumped into the State Farm Center to make it what I think is arguably the best collegiate game venue in the country. We've got unbelievable tradition, obviously one of the top 15 programs in terms of wins over the course of our history. The Orange Crush is unbelievable. Our fans, the atmosphere. There are a lot of things that can be sold about Illinois basketball. And I think that is a much better story to tell than the fact that, look, we've fallen on some hard times here in recent years. We haven't won as many games as we would like. The reality is that there is no limit on what this program can accomplish. And obviously, we've got a great recruiting class on the way in. I think we return a really talented, capable nucleus of players for next year. So I don't think that the cupboard is bare. I think the cupboard's in a pretty good spot. And we can be optimistic about what the future holds. And we want to find a head coach who shares in that optimism and wants to be a part of leading the program to realize that full potential.
Given that this recruiting class is kind of in limbo for the next coach, obviously you want to get the right guy, but how important is speed in getting this coach here?
Well, Well, you never sacrifice quality for speed. Certainly, in a perfect world, we'd like to do both. I'm not a big fan. You've seen it with the few searches I've done. I don't like to leave things open for very long. I think it lends itself to a lot of uncertainty. You get current players who might start to think about going elsewhere. You get assistant coaches who don't know what's going on. You've got recruits who are kind of out there wondering what's going to happen. So the less time we can have with it vacant, the better. But you're not going to move fast and give up the opportunity to get the right person. And so you have to try and find that balance.
Lord, do you have anything to clarify as far as the women's program is concerned?
You know, I don't. I've had so much going on here these last couple of weeks. I've been traveling a lot. I haven't had an opportunity to complete an assessment with that program. I look forward to doing that here in the coming days, but I haven't had a chance to do that yet.
Josh, you've been AD at other schools. You've probably had to make a lot of tough decisions. This the toughest?
It was the most personal. It was the most personal. Yeah, it's no secret that John and I have gotten to be good friends. And I admire a lot of things about him. And I hope that, you know, that's a relationship that can endure after he's gone. I hope that, you know, I had a chance to, when you're an athletic director, you come in, you have to think about how you want to do your business. And sometimes I think athletic directors make the decision that, in one person's words, they're going to use the Heisman pose, right? They're going to keep everybody at arm's length because at the end of the day, you may have to make a decision like this one. Other ADs, and I fall in this camp, choose to wrap their arms around people and get close to them and be in the foxhole with them and be a part of their day-to-day experience, a part of their day-to-day successes and failures. And, you know, the reality is that if I had kept John at arm's length for this last year, today's decision would be a lot easier. But I would have had a lot worse time the last 365 some odd days. But I made the decision to pull him close. And that made the last 13, 14 months a whole lot better. Makes the day a lot harder. And so on the whole, I would choose the way I do it because I like all the other days, even though it makes this day tougher. So have I made harder decisions? Maybe, but never one that maybe hurt quite so much.
Anything else for Josh today? Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Did you have a chance to talk to any of the recruits about, I guess, having a different coach than the coach that recruited them?
Yeah, so I communicated with the recruits today. I texted all four of them, and I told them that I'd be in touch with them over the next couple days to actually speak with them about what that might look like, what the process will be, what our timeline is. You know, it's hard in these moments. Thanks a lot to you guys, that how fast information travels. It's really delicate to try and put together a process at these moments where the right people are hearing about it in the right way. And so sometimes the result of that is you end up communicating in a bit of an impersonal manner, but it's more important that they hear about it from you than from someone else. So that was how we approached the recruits today.
Okay. Thank you, Josh.
Okay. Thank you, everybody.